Hey everyone, Howard Pinsky here with a very old Photoshop tutorial. Now, it's nothing that I've done in the past, but today I'm going to be showing you guys how you can create an old stained paper texture that kind of looks like an ancient treasure map, all with just layer styles and filters. Let me show you how this works. The size of the starting document isn't too important for this tutorial, but I'm going to be starting with a 1920 by 1080 pixel document, and it's going to be filled with a very dark brown, which will appear eventually behind the paper. The first layer that we're going to be creating will be the base for the paper. So in your layers panel, create a new layer, and then we're going to fill it with a lighter brown. I'm going to be using the value E1CAB0. Now once the foreground color has been set, you can quickly fill your layer by holding down your Option key on the Mac or Alt key on Windows and pressing Delete or Backspace. Now that the paper layer is in place, let's start applying a few filters. But before you do, make sure to convert the layer into a smart object so you can easily edit those filters at a later point. Good, the first filter will be noise, just to give a subtle hint of speckling. 3.5%, uniform, and monochromatic should give you a nice texture. Now that the noise is in place, we'll be able to add our next filter, which can be found in the filter gallery. Once the filter gallery is up, expand the artistic section and choose the underpainting filter. This will add some chipping and fraying to the paper texture. The settings usually come down to personal preference, but I'm going to max out the brush size and texture coverage, and then set the texture to burlap with a scaling of 200% and a relief of 5. Press OK to apply the final filter. Next, we need to create an additional layer to really give some age to our design. Once again, create a new layer, and this time, go ahead and clip it to the paper layer. This can be done by holding down Alt or Option, and then placing your cursor right in between those two layers until you see the downwards arrow, and then click. This may seem pointless now, but it'll make sense shortly once we add a layer mask. To start off this texture, we're going to fill it with a simple clouds filter, but again, before that's done, convert your layer into a smart object. As the clouds filter uses your foreground and background colors, set them to black and white by pressing the D key on your keyboard. Now that the colors have been set, head up to the filter menu, down to render, and then choose clouds to fill in your new layer. Obviously, we're not going to be sticking with our black and white clouds, but we're going to be using them to interact with the previous layer using our blend modes. Go ahead and double click on your layer to bring up the layer styles dialog and stay within the blending options section. We're going to first change the blend mode to color burn in order to, well, burn the previous layer. And already that's looking quite nice, but just to pull back some of the harsher tones in this layer, we can use the blend if option at the bottom. With your Alt or Option key held down, drag the right side of the shadow slider to the right until you're happy with the result. Of course, if you like the way this looked before the adjustment, you can certainly leave the blend if option alone. Now you could stop here, but that would be boring. To take this a step further, let's add a nice border around our paper. Go ahead and select the original paper layer in your layers panel, and with your rectangular marquee tool, draw out a selection around the paper about an inch in from the edge of the document. When the selection has been made, add a layer mask to hide what was outside of that selection, revealing the brown layer underneath. Now, in order to create ripped edges, we're going to be applying filters to the layer mask rather than the layer itself. The first filter will be a wave distortion in order to get rid of any boring straight edges. The settings you use may differ from mine depending on the size of your document. For this size, the values you see here will give me nice waves around the layer. If you want fewer or more waves, you can adjust the max wavelength value. Once you apply the wave filter, you'll probably notice that the edges are way too smooth. In order to roughen them up, we're going to add one more filter to the layer mask. This time, back in the filter gallery, choose the spatter filter, which is in the brush stroke section. A spray radius of around 13 and a smoothness of 8 should give your edges a nice, rough, torn look to them. Finally, to finish off this design and to add a little bit of depth to our paper, let's add a few layer styles, starting with an inner shadow. Set the blend mode to overlay, the opacity at 100%, the distance at 0, and then crank up the size to around 50 pixels in order to darken up the edges a touch. And lastly, an inner glow to darken up the edges even more. For this style, set the blend mode to color burn, and then increase the size a touch to around 12 pixels. Press OK to see your final result. Now, at any point in the future, if you want the texture to extend right to the edges of your document, you can hold down your Shift key and click on the layer mask in order to disable it. And that's that. I hope you guys enjoyed that tutorial. As always, make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel to be kept up to date with all my new content. Check out my website, ICEFLOWSTUDIOS.com. And if you want to support the work that I do, check out patreon.com/HowardPinsky, which allows you, as viewers, to tip content creators like myself for the videos that we produce. So check me out, patreon.com/HowardPinsky. And until next time, take care.